Do you know that you can add custom payloads to the SQL map? This tool is powerful out of the box, but with advanced customization, you can unleash its full potential. Let's get ready to improve your SQL injection automation skills. There are many ways how people usually customize SQL map, like using extra headers, random user agents, tampering scripts, or delays between requests. Fine-tuning those options could sometimes help to fuzz specific endpoints or avoid web application firewall rules. Although this tool is pretty good by its defaults, you could still add your own twist into it. Certain configuration files describe the payloads the SQL map sends. For different people, those configuration files might be in different locations. It depends on which operating system you use, how you install it, do you already have it in your operating system like Kali Linux or Parrot OS, and etc. What it comes down to are those particular XML files, as we can see on the GitHub SQL map repository right here. There are different types of SQL injection payloads described in each of the files. For example, let's look into boolean blind XML file. So yeah, this file does contain the most explanation how you can build your own SQL map query. It does contain a comment where it actually explains everything what you need to do. There is a root, and inside that root there are multiple test cases written. So if we read through this explanation, like this title is just title of the test, S type. There are like multiple values where you can write down. So if you are constructing boolean based SQL injection, it will be value of 1, error based 2, blah blah blah. So inside different types of those files, there will be S types of different numbers. So if I like go through all of them, you will see the S type changes. Next, if we check the level, and also about S types, there, as you can see, there are boolean error based stacked queries. If you are using SQL map and you want to like only execute time based, so you have to write down technique equals T, like the first letter of the like type of the SQL injection is usually just selects all of, like not all queries, but queries from that file, because on each of that file it's separated by S type. So in this case, if I write down like technique equals T, it will run queries from this file. But it doesn't mean that it run all the queries, because there are other things as well, like level. So it will also explain right here, if you have a lot of time and you want to run like over 1000 requests, you could select level of 5. So basically it will run all those described payloads, but it has to be up to level 5, so like level 5 and lower. So if I, for example, select level 3, it will run 1, 2 and 3 level payloads. So, and on the SQL map it will look like this, SQL level equals 3. And there is also another subtag which is also important, the risk. So it is the likelihood of payload to damage data integrity. So if you use like high risk queries, those queries have likelihood that you could destroy something on the server. So don't do this on production servers. If it's OIT, testing environment, staging environment, you are good to go, but don't do this on production, because if you damage something, you might be like, you might get in trouble. So have this in mind. And others are also like, there are much of things which you could read, but let me quickly scroll through and like show the good example. So I guess today we're gonna be building a time-based query, and let's open this file. It's called time-blind XML, and what I suggest you to do is just add and like copy this one and add something right here, but you need to do it on your own server. And of course, if you want to use risk, there is also another flag for risk. But in order to find file like this, if you not installed from the source, from the GitHub, if it's installed on like your operating system, usually there are a couple of ways to install SQLMap. So either you could use pip/free to install. In that case, it will be like this. Files like this will be located somewhere on your home directory under .configure, I think, or .local if you install through pip. If you use package managers like apt using Ubuntu, Kali Linux, ParrotOS, but on ParrotOS and Kali Linux it will be already installed. If you use apt, for example, if you have Ubuntu, Debian, it will be installed somewhere under usr share. But just in case you don't know where those files are located, you could use find command, use slash, because it will be as the starting point, use name, and give the file name that you are looking for. So in this case it's time-blind XML, and you can also specify the type. It will be file, not directory. And I hit enter. It will give a lot of permission denied, but you can ignore those. Additionally, at the end of that command, you can even like write down to exclude those. Actually use this at the end. Like this. And you won't be getting those errors. So yeah, as you can see, user share SQL map data XML payload. So let's switch to that directory, and we will be editing time blind XML. You can use nano, but I will be using VS Code for that. So if you noticed, I already created my own payload right here and pasted at the top. So it is XOR time-based blind query sleep. I have written down S type of 5 because it's time-based, and all time-based in this file is S type 5. Risk and level is 1. And of course, another thing about SQLMap, by default it uses level and risk 1. So if I use this query, the SQLMap will run it as default. So it's pretty good to use level and risk by 1 if it's not really risky. The clause I copied from the following payload, where I also copied, and the payload itself is right here and right here. So basically those are just variables. This variable will randomize number, and this will randomize string, and there is this sleep inside if function, and there is the sleep time. So every time, like unless you specify, every time the SQL map runs, it will assign any number. It could be 12, 10 seconds. It's really like depends on the SQL map, how that program decides. And I also added some details of what it could be MySQL, but I think I should remove this because usually it's, as it is pretty generic, I could also remove this. So if you want to run only this specific query, I'm not sure if it's possible, but to run like to make sure that this query will be ran, what you could do is just use SQLMap with technique equals t and like specify the URL. So like test PHP will web, like list product. You could try on this one because They also like included that one. And let's see if our query will be executed. It shows that it has possibility of XSS attack. It's pretty interesting feature of SQLMap. And you can see like immediately our XOR time-based blind sleep query is being executed. We could additionally try like switching values a little bit as well, but I suggest if you want to include any other payload, just copy this and like modify vector and payload parts. Those are like actually the most important for the sleep queries at least. That was all for this video. Hopefully you learned something new. Feel free to check out my Patreon page. I have added behind the scenes videos where I do show workspace setup. There are free videos of that, each for different purpose. This is currently reachable for paid members, but seriously, it costs less than a meal to be a member. And as always, thank you for watching and enjoy the journey.